Hello, 3D printing friends. Today on the BV3D channel, we'll learn how to design a little thing in Tinkercad to hold another thing. Stick around and we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. This episode of the BV3D channel is brought to you in part by these awesome channel members. Hi, welcome back. Hey, if you're new here and you're wanting to learn about 3D printing, 3D modeling, and other 3D printing related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, so today we're going to design and print a holder for these cheap combination thermometer and hygrometer things. So sometimes it feels really humid here, and I wanted to have a better idea of the temperature and relative humidity levels in various rooms in the house. Now I have this one analog thermometer hygrometer thing, but it's kind of big and it takes a while for it to do its thing when moved from one room to another. Well, then I remembered that Repcord uses a round hygrometer thing on the rep box, so I did a quick search for something like that on Amazon, and I ended up buying a 4-pack of these things for about 16 bucks, but you can find other ones on there for less. Anyway, I got these because I liked the look of them. They're round, not rectangular like most of them, and to me that just looked better. So they come with extra batteries and peel and stick circles, so you can put them wherever you want. And while that may work fine, they're clearly designed to mount into a cutout in a panel or something. So I wanted to make something these would snap into that would be a little more decorative than just being stuck to the wall. So I grabbed my calipers and then it was off to Tinkercad, where I took some measurements and made a hole piece to make the appropriate panel cutout shape. Now this consists of a cylinder that's 42 millimeters in diameter and 20 millimeters tall. That 20 millimeter tallness is the default for the cylinder. I just changed the X and Y values to 42. Because not only is 42 the answer to the great question of life, the universe, and everything, it's also exactly 1 millimeter larger than the actual diameter of the back part of the hygrometer. Then, to accommodate the snap tabs that hold the hygrometer in place, I added a rectangle that's 43 millimeters wide by 6 millimeters deep by 20 millimeters tall. So by grouping those two hole parts together, I have something that will cut an appropriately sized hole in, well, in anything else in Tinkercad. The anything else in this case should be some flat surface that's between about 3 and 4 millimeters thick. I thought it would look kind of like a bit of art if I put the hygrometer in a four-sided pyramid. Kind of like that all-seeing eye, or whatever you call it, on the back of a dollar bill. Only in this case, it would be the all-seeing hygrometer. So out comes a four-sided pyramid, and I'll scale it up to 94 by 94 by 94 millimeters. Now, I really only want the square base and one face of the pyramid. I'm going for a minimalistic art piece here. So what I can do is duplicate the pyramid and then move it up about 3 millimeters and move it back about 6 millimeters and turn that duplicate into a hole type part and then group them together. And when I do that, I get a shape that suggests a four-sided pyramid, but it's really just a square and a triangle. Okay, so I have a cool shape, but now I need to use that cutout that I made a few minutes ago. So I'll select it and copy it to the clipboard. And now I'm going to show you a cool trick in Tinkercad. I'm going to change where the work plane is. Normally it's just flat on the bottom where you expect it, but Tinkercad has this cool feature that lets you put the work plane on any face of an object. So I'll drag a work plane out onto the triangular face of this thing that we're making. See what it did? Now any further objects that get added will be flat relative to the work plane's position. So since I copied the cutout to the clipboard, when I paste it, boom! Now it's perfectly angled to rest on that triangular face. I want to center it horizontally on that triangle, and I can use the alignment tool for that. I'll select both objects, click the align tool, and then click here to center them. And then I'll click away from those objects to dismiss the align tool. I'll adjust the vertical alignment by eye. There, that's about where I want it. And finally, I need to actually cut this shape out of the pyramid. So I'll select it, and then I'll use this cone-shaped control to push it down through the triangular face just far enough to cut the shape out. And to complete the cut, I'll select the pyramid and the cutout and group them together. it might be a good idea to return the work plane to its usual place, so drag a work plane item out to where the work plane usually lives, and it'll reset. Okay, so now export this to an STL file, slice it up, and print it out. I'm using Prusa Slicer for this, and I actually want to print it on its side to increase its strength. So after dropping it onto the plater, I'll click the face plant button and select one of the sides that doesn't exist, and it'll flop over like this. I'm also going to turn on supports on build plate only and then slice it. And it looks like this. I'm going to print this in a silk gold PLA because I think that'll look nice with the black ring around the hygrometer. So here's a time lapse of it printing. And here's the finished product ready for the hygrometer. So I'll snap that in, lining up the tabs with the notches here on the round cutout. And then I can just rotate it a bit until it's lined up and level. There, now I have a fun way to display the hygrometer and thermometer. Plus, it's open on the back, so there's plenty of airflow, which means it'll be able to quickly sense the temperature and the relative humidity. And I think it looks pretty cool. Oh, if you find that it's hard to rotate the hygrometer after snapping it in, try unsnapping it and then line it up level and snap it in place. Personally, I've found that it's more difficult to line it up level and snap it in, but your mileage, as they say, may vary. If you don't feel like flexing your skills in Tinkercad to design one of these yourself, I have two versions of it up on printables.com. One version is the one that we just designed, and the other is one that I spent a little extra time on to add a curve to the front of it, so you can see there. So you can download and print whichever one you like best, or of course you can completely design one of your own. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this episode. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool. Hey, real quick before you go, I wanted to say thanks for being one of the super awesome people who sticks around all the way to the end, and thanks for all the likes, comments, and shares. And an especially big thanks to those who directly support what I do. You're all wonderful for doing that, and I really appreciate it. If you liked this episode, a thumbs up would be great, and if you'd like to help support the channel, check the description for ways you can do exactly that. And hey, if you haven't already subscribed, please do. It's absolutely free, and it's an excellent way to help keep me making these videos for you. Well, that's it for this one. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time here on the BV3D channel.